Welcome back. In this special telecast, we tell you about the front seat view that India Today got of Prime Minister Modi's August 16 interaction with the Olympic heroes. There were funny anecdotes, there were selfies, there were words of encouragement and precisely boosting the morale of the players who came back victorious, but also perhaps an encouraging note for the Paralympian athletes who are set to depart for their events as well. Take a look at what precisely happened when Prime Minister Modi met, chatted, had an ice cream with all the Olympians that had gone to Tokyo.
Paramadaniya Narendra Modi ji, hum sab ke beech mein aaye hain. Kartal Dhwani se inka bahut bahut swagat, bahut bahut abhinandan.
अब आपका पेट का दर्द ठीक हो गया? एकदम परफेक्ट. अच्छा,
आपके आशीर्वाद
से. चलिए बहुत आगे बढ़िए. थोड़े निराश हो गए थे. चलिए होता रहता है, लेकिन बहुत काम किया आपने.
पूछो एकदम आप.
उनके तो निराश थे. मम्मी पापा प्रसन्न है. वाह वाह.
इसी से
ये मैं ऑक्शन करूँगा. मेला पड़ गया.
एक महीने
पहले पैर का भी हाल खराब था.
इंजरी
आकर के कुछ किया क्या? अभी भी अभी घूम रहे हो? ठीक हो एकदम? आसाम हो
एक
दे.
मैंने बैठी है.
लेकिन ये पहनूंगा मैं तो पॉलिटिक्स की मैं लोग कहेंगे कि अब मोदी कुछ गड़बड़ करने वाला है. मैं इसको ऑक्शन कर सकता हूँ ताकि मैं इसमें से कुछ सेवा के काम करता हूँ. चलिए बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं. बहुत धन्यवाद. शान रखिए.
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू सो मच.
उस दिन तो बात हुई थी, तुम जा रहे थे.
बिल्कुल सर.
सर आप
सबका सिग्नेचर है. बहुत बधाई. नाउ कैन यू स्पीक पंजाबी और नॉट?
उपेंद्र पाल सिंह.
कितने हाइट है? तो वॉलीबॉल बने गए. मैं इसका ऑक्शन करता हूँ.
ठीक है सर.
और मैं सबसे आग्रह करूँगा जो स्कूल में हॉकी अच्छी खेलते हैं वो इसको ले जाए. ताकि आप लोगों का ये स्मृति देख करके उनको भी नई प्रेरणा मिलेगी. बहुत बहुत बधाई पूरी टीम को. बहुत बधाई. अच्छा नीरज, ये बताइए, सचमुच मैं बड़ा मेरे लिए सरप्राइज था जब तुमने सेकेंड बार अपना किया तो तुमने विक्टरी के मूड में आ गए और एकदम विक्टरी तुम सेलिब्रेट करने लग गए. इसके पीछे बहुत बड़ा कॉन्फिडेंस है. पूरी जानकारी लगती है तब संभव होता है. और खिलाड़ियों के संबंध में भी जानकारी होगी क्या हो रहा है वहाँ. तो कैसे कैसे संभव हुआ?
वो थ्रो में जो एफर्ट लगता है क्योंकि इतने साल से हम ट्रेनिंग कर रहे हैं उसी चीज़ के लिए, तो वो एफर्ट बता देता है कि हाँ ये बेस्ट थ्रो है। और सबसे बड़ी बात है जो कॉन्फिडेंस है वो ट्रेनिंग से आता है सर, ट्रेनिंग इतने अच्छे से हुई थी इतने साल, तो इसलिए कॉन्फिडेंस था।
नीरज इतना नहीं है क्योंकि तुम्हें ये तो मालूम है कि भाई तुम 85 जाओगे 86 जाओगे, तुम्हें मालूम है, ठीक है, तुम्हें औरों का पता नहीं है वो 90 जाएगा कि 88 जाएगा कितना 84 जाएगा। ऐसे में ये मिजाज, और तुम शायद अपने आप को कभी बैठ करके सोचो, यानी एक मित्र के रूप में सलाह देता हूँ, ठीक है तुम्हें नॉर्मल से कुछ एक्स्ट्रा ऑर्डिनरी परमात्मा की गिफ्ट है। कभी तुम्हारे मम्मी पापा ने मार किया होगा, क्योंकि मैंने देखा है कि विजय तुम्हारे सर पे नहीं चढ़ता है, और दूसरा मैंने देखा है कि पराजय तुम्हारे मन में नहीं बैठता है। ये दोनों चीज़ें बहुत बड़ी हैं, और ये मैं तुम्हें जब भी तुमसे बात किया है हर बार बड़ा बैलेंसिंग चीज़ें देखी है, कुछ तो होगा जी।
सर वो तो हमारा स्पोर्ट्स ऐसा है कि मतलब अपोनेंट पे निर्भर तो करता है, लेकिन हमें अपना बेस्ट देना होता है। मतलब हम फाइनल इकट्ठे खेलते हैं, 12 लोग होते हैं, लेकिन उन एथलीट्स के बीच में हमें अपने आप पे फोकस करना होता है, हमें बस अपना ही बेस्ट करना होता है। तो कोशिश यही करता हूँ कि दूसरे की परफॉर्मेंस की तरफ ध्यान ना देके या उसकी परफॉर्मेंस को देख के नर्वस ना होके अपनी परफॉर्मेंस कैसे बेटर करनी है उस पर फोकस करूँ।
गर्म है माहौल जब से आप हॉकी जीत करके आए हो। हॉकी की जो विक्ट्री है यार, आपने और बेटियों ने दोनों ने कमाल किया है, और भारत ओलंपिक में कितना ही जीत ले लेकिन अगर हॉकी नहीं जीतता है तो इस देश को फील ही नहीं होता कि वो जीत हुई है।
थैंक यू सो मच।
को तो है तब पंजाबी सीखना पड़ेगा तुझे।
नहीं सर, मैं लोगों को मलयालम सिखाता हूँ अभी।
क्योंकि गोल कीपर को तो सबको सूचना देता रहता है ना।
सर आप जिस टाइम हम लोग जब सेमीफाइनल हारने के बाद बात किए हैं सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच, क्योंकि जब जीतने के बाद सब हम लोग को तारीफ करते हैं, बट जब हारने के बाद जिस टाइम आपका फ़ोन कॉल आ गया सर, वो हमारे लिए बहुत ज़्यादा एक मोटिवेशन था।
मैं फिर से एक बार आप सबका यहाँ स्वागत करता हूँ, और आप तो सब पराक्रमी लोग हैं, परिश्रमी लोग हैं, और देश की आन बान शान बढ़ाने वाले लोग हैं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Remember this grand welcome, not just for the ones who got a medal, but also for the whole Indian contingent at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. And I have the pleasure today to have some of those players who had met the Prime Minister to tell us precisely what was the mood like at that event. And one by one, we'll be joined by more. I, of course, want to first go across to one of the hockey players, not only the hockey team, perhaps bringing the cheer for the country that I think no other team event possibly could. I'm joined by Surinder Kumar. He's the defender. He's also known as the Mr. Dependable. I'm also joined by Trupti Murgunde. I'm joined by Arboria Majumdar, who was tracking each and every day there at Tokyo Olympics. I'm also joined by Rahi Sarnobat. She's also 2020 Tokyo Olympic in Olympian in shooting. And many more will continue to join us. First, I want to go across to Surinder Kumar. आप मिस्टर डिपेंडेबल ज़रूर जाने जाते हैं, जब इस एज अ टीम आप लोग मिलते हैं प्रधानमंत्री से, आपको लगता है ये जो मोमेंट था ये एक बूस्ट होता है, मोराल होता है पूरी टीम के लिए, ना कि सिर्फ कैप्टन को बुलाया गया पर पूरी टीम से मुलाकात हुई, क्या प्रधानमंत्री ने आपको स्पेसिफिकली कुछ कहा उस दिन?
नहीं मैडम, जैसे टीम के बारे में बोला, सबसे पहले तो हम थैंक्स करना चाहते हैं अपने प्रधानमंत्री जी का कि उन्होंने सभी एथलीट्स को जो टोक्यो ओलंपिक्स में गए थे सभी का मोरल अप किया है बात करके। देखो जब जीतते हैं तो सबके फोन आते हैं, सब बात कर लेते हैं, बट हारने के बाद जो मंत्री जी ने हमारे से बात की सभी लड़कों से और कैप्टन से, तो उसमें बड़ा अच्छा मतलब कॉन्फिडेंस मिलता है उससे अगले मैच के लिए, तो बहुत अच्छी चीज़ है। अगर ऐसे ही जैसे देश के प्रधानमंत्री जी ऐसे ही अगर आगे भी टूर्नामेंटों में ऐसे ही प्लेयरों का कॉन्फिडेंस बढ़ाएंगे तो बहुत अच्छी चीज़ है प्लेयर्स के लिए।
थैंक यू सो मच सुरेंद्र हमसे बात कहने के लिए। कि सिर्फ जीतने पर तो काफ़ी फ़ोन कॉल्स आते हैं, लेकिन हारे तो नहीं आप, लेकिन फिर भी जो मेडल मिला शायद और आगे तक जाने की उम्मीद थी उस पर भी एक फ़ोन कॉल आना, प्रधानमंत्री की तरफ से फिर भी एक वर्ड आना, वो भी काफ़ी मैटर करता है टीम के मोराल के लिए। आई वांट टू गो अक्रॉस नाउ टू तृप्ति मुरगुंडे। तृप्ति, यू आर अ कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स ब्रॉन्ज मेडलिस्ट, यू हैव ऑल्सो कवर्ड एज अ कॉमेंटेटर दिस टाइम द टोक्यो ओलंपिक्स। व्हेन अ प्राइम मिनिस्टर meets the team members, meets the athletes, whether or not they have won. You also met Dr. Manmohan Singh when you had got that medal. Do you think a lot has changed since then, from now? If there is a change, what at all?
Yes, totally. I mean, I must say that I'm pretty envious about the current way the sports is going on, and at the same time, very happy for them. It's been a very motivating gesture by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, sir. And I think the way he has motivated, he has invited the entire contingent, not only the medal winners, but also the entire contingent who has participated in Olympics, and motivated them at inviting them for the Independence Day, and also having an interaction over a breakfast. I think it's really inspiring. And I mean, back in my days when we got back, we never had this sort of welcome. We never had even the send-off. Was not. I think this time the entire nation has come together and supported the Indian contingent. It's really heartening to see that this kind of support is there for sports. And I would also like to mention that the last Olympics, which was in Rio, we just had, everybody was disappointed with the fact that we just had two medals. But post that, one good part was that the sports didn't go down. In fact, it started going upwards with the kind of support started coming in from government, their involvement to better the number of medals. So I think, immediately I remember that there was an Olympic task force which was formed to, analyze what went wrong in the Rio Olympics. And year after year, we started doing better. So it's not that the results have come now, yes, but it was a process which, was followed, and the results we have seen right now. I mean, I really feel happy with the fact that when you have a prime minister calling you after having a loss, it's really tough to digest the fourth position. There's a lot of difference between a fourth position and being a medal winner.
That, so what you're telling us is very important, yes. And Tripti, because you've been a badminton player, we saw the manner in which the badminton as a sporting event has also got a boost. And of course, it's been successive governments, but primarily to welcome them and welcome all of them is a grand gesture as well. I want to go across to Borya Majumdar as well, who was there on the ground tracking all the latest. Borya, of course, there are these official meetings that do take place. There are celebrations that take place officially as well. How do we say this event was different? Was it perhaps just how it was projected, or it definitely meant a lot more to the teams and to the players who met the Prime Minister, who was constantly reacting and tweeting when the events, even when the players did not win a medal for the country?
See, that is what the point is. The last part of what you said, Pooja, is actually what the difference is. Because before the games, the Prime Minister interacted.
Yes.
During the games, the Prime Minister was tweeting. The Prime Minister was hands-on. After the games, the Prime Minister is hands-on. What has that done? Why is Pooja Shali doing this show on prime time at India Today, on India Today television today? Because the Prime Minister did this. And you are not alone. The newspapers have covered it, television media has covered it, we as journalists have covered it. What has it done? It has mainstreamed Olympic sport. You won Lords and cricket. What are you doing at 6:30? You're doing Olympic sport. Why? Because it has become a brand. With the Prime Minister getting in, the Olympic sporting echelon has all of a sudden been elevated to that pedestal where brands and corporate India will look, because they know the political class is behind it. The Prime Minister interacted with para-athletes, which I think is fantastic, because the Paralympics are coming. So
yes,
all of a sudden, you have a movement. And that is what mainstream sport in this country. I'm delighted with what is going on.
That's very true, because this country definitely needs more sporting icons, and the fact that they are putting in so much effort, that has come to the fore this time. It's not just one sport that needs all our focus, and that's why we are doing this special telecast today. Borean, I request all of you to please stay on with me. Remember, it is not just about return and congratulations. It's also about an inspiring send-off. The Paralympics also are set to now begin on 24th of August. That send-off also was given by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. He met the Paralympic athletes. I'm now joined by Ekta Bhayan as well. She's a Paralympian. Now, Ekta, when the Prime Minister decides to meet not just the Olympians, so to say, ignoring the Paralympians, this time also meeting the para-athletes as well, do you think that's exactly the boost that these athletes also need, that they are not perhaps an isolated event or isolated athletes, they are as much a part of the sporting movement?
The big part of the sport is that every athlete is putting that part. Either they are the able-bodied athletes or the para-athletes. And when the Prime Minister is addressing us, so it is setting a right example in the rest of the country that we are also the players and we are not just a disabled person. We are also the players and bringing laurels to our country. So this has really boosted our confidence, and we are confident that we make our country proud at the Paralympics with medals in double digits.
So Ekta, here via you as well, I want to wish all our Paralympic athletes as well all the very best. Remember, it begins on 24th August. They've already met the Prime Minister yesterday, so an inspiring send-off there. And remember, it does mean a lot to these athletes who otherwise are not even in news through the year. I want to now bring in Bhavani Devi, the first fencer to participate representing India at 2020 Tokyo Olympics. She went as far as she possibly could. Bhavani, when you met the Prime Minister, did he say anything special to you? Because he had been inspiring you via social media already. He had given out tweets calling you Bhavani metaphorically as well. How was the meeting when you met him?
Thank you. So I was so honored to be there in the past few days in Delhi to meet all the athletes, to be at Rashtrapati Bhavan, and to have met Honorable Prime Minister of India at his residence, because I never thought these things would happen in my life, because I started my fencing career only dreaming about Olympics. And at the beginning, many people told me it is not possible for an Indian to reach that level. But I just wanted to try to achieve that feat. And when I achieved that, everyone got to believe that, you know, if Indians can do well in fencing also. And especially when I was at the PM's residence, every second for me, it was so, I was so happy and so honored to be with all the athletes, because in this COVID pandemic situation, I have invited all the athletes, not only the Olympic medalists. So that is more very important support for all the athletes, not only for us, but the entire nation. So for athletes, we need that kind of moral support and encouragement to move on to the next level, to keep going on, to keep working harder to win medal in the upcoming tournament. So I think it is very important support, and we have received from the Honorable Prime Minister of India, and
that's
I'm sure
great.
This will inspire all the athletes to work harder for the nation.
And I want to tell our guests today that you have been inspiring us in the past few days. The moments that we have got, thanks to your effort, your struggle, you've given hope to so many more Indians, especially the younger people who would want to now pursue sports. It's all thanks to you, and perhaps a very deserving acknowledgement coming for all of you from Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Thank you so much for joining us today evening with this special telecast. Remember, the Paralympics also are now beginning on 24th August, and we hope to get many more medals there as well. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned to India Today.